Abhinetri Shweta, Ms. Joshi, welcome to Box Office India.
Thank you.
Hi, Bhavi.
Hi, and congratulations for the trailer. It's really interesting.
You saw it?
Yeah, I watched it like so many times.
thank you very much.
So, first of all, the question is to you, Ms. Abhinetri. You know, this subject is such that many people do not know about it. So, where does this idea come from?
Exactly from the same point of view that not many people know about it. And in fact, one of the 2nd October's few years ago, I was seeing, and I've been observing for a long time that all we remember on 2nd October is Gandhiji, and nobody remembers that the second Prime Minister was also born on the same day, a great leader. So one day, 2-3 years ago, I just tweeted that today is also Shastriji's birthday, let's not forget that. And then so many people, you know, all the Twitter, you know, all the youngsters, they follow me a lot. So they started saying, why don't you make a film on Shastriji's mysterious death? And the mysterious death, that's what appealed me a lot. And I said, everybody wants to make films on somebody's life. Here people are asking me to make a film on somebody's death. So I'm absolutely not a conspiracy theory kind of a person. I'm not the one who believes ki moon pe koi gya nahi tha and all that kind of things. But I asked one of my assistants, and we were free. I was writing my book at that time, and he was also free because of that. So I said, why don't you figure out yaar kuch hai to dekhte hain story, like a typical Bollywood kind of a person. Chalo kuch kahani hai to isme nikalte hain. But then I realized that there's some information which is being presented in many ways on this thing. And then I said ki if we have to make a film on this, we should authenticate all the information. And for almost a year, we turned whistleblowers and we filed lots of RTIs. All the RTIs, only one reply came, that all ministry, foreign ministry, home ministry, PMO, that we have no information on Shastri, no document. I said, the second Prime Minister of India, and we have no information on his death. He went there, could log bana hoga that he met so many people. There must be some log of his health, you know, his pulse and blood pressure. There's nothing. And that's when Pallavi and I said, you know, this is a serious thing. And the premise was that I said, we have no right to truth. You know, anything can happen and you will never get to know the truth of anything. Do you think in your waking hours have you got to know about any truth? No.
No, nothing.
Nothing. Any scam, scandal, political murder, you'll never get to know the truth. So we said we should make this film about the right to truth, and the right to truth should begin with your Prime Minister. If you don't know the truth about him, how will you know the truth about anything else? Correct. That's how this film came about.
Correct. And you know, making a film on such subjects needs a lot of research. So while making the film, what kind of research you had done?
Okay, so after this, when we realized that we are not going in any direction, so I released a video and I said I want to crowdsource research. So everybody said, people crowdsource funding, how come, what is this? So people thought it's a joke or something, but no, it wasn't a joke, I meant it because I wanted to know. And people do that. If you see scientists do that, researchers in various disciplines, they do it.
Yeah.
Generally, you see lots of times there are ads also, people appeal that, give me any information you have. Government also does it many times, but film industry has never used this tool. So I did that, and then thousands, and I knew if you go to politicians, you'll get a certain kind of prejudice, bias, this thing. If I employ film industry researchers, and they won't be able to handle the politics of it, you know. So, but when the information and the research material started coming from general public, that started opening my eyes, because that kind of some of the information was not available anywhere. And they also led me to people and authorities and agencies from where it became very easy for me to derive information, to like KGB secret papers, which I didn't know about. I wouldn't have gone in that direction. CIA secret papers, I wouldn't have gone in that direction. There are books, you know, which are popular on Shastri's death from CIA. But the counter books, there are no counter books. So you find them in FBI secret documents and all those things. So that's how the whole research came. So it took about 3.5 years of my prime youth.
Right. And Shweta, Ms. Joshi, thought about you, like your character seems very intriguing, and it is very strong also in the trailer that we have seen. So can you shed some more light on your character? What is it about?
I think Shweta should go first because she carries the whole film on her shoulders.
My character's name is Ragini Phule. She's a rookie journalist, and she starts off as this really ambitious young girl who gathers a lot of scoops and scandals and eyeball-catching headlines and fake news, fake stories, fabricated statements, because she thinks that's what will take her higher in the ladder. Till she comes across the Tashkent files, and in it was, the case about the mysterious demise of our former Prime Minister, Shri Lal Bahadur Shastri Ji. And she starts researching and in that process unraveling the mystery. And how she gets obsessed with it. If you've seen the trailer, you know, she gets obsessed with it. You can gather that. And eventually she understands that it's not just, of course, it is a sensitive topic, it's a subject that she's researching on, and she's taken it up to like really research and do something about it. But she realizes eventually that it's about a citizen's fundamental right to truth. And that's what it becomes eventually for her. For me, Ragini Phule represents the fourth estate of democracy, which is media. And it's in a way also an ode to hard, honest journalists, because it's not a very easy profession. There are a lot of sacrifices, there's a lot at stake, a lot of risk. We hear about political journalists disappearing, dying under mysterious circumstances. Yeah. So she's one of those who's really fighting for truth. She's a truth seeker, and she's like any other citizen or youth in this country who don't refrain from asking questions. They're not afraid for seeking truth.
Right. Well, you know, surprisingly, I started thinking about my character very, very late, right? Almost before we started shooting, a few days before we started shooting. Because this was a home production and we were so busy with everything else, setting the creative in place, casting, the look, the costumes, the color palettes. And then it suddenly dawned on me one day when the schedules were laid out and we knew we'll be going to the set soon. And I realized that I haven't done anything, I haven't even thought about my character, I haven't thought about the look. So then the next 3 days, 4 days, I think, I just took off and I said, enough, I'm going to start being a producer now. So it was a fun film. The reason I say fun, because I've never experienced, a camaraderie on the sets like this. On one hand, we had exceptionally brilliant and solidly experienced actors like we also had some absolute pleasurable actors to work with, like Pankaj Tripathi, who we didn't know kab kya aane wala hai kahan se. Then we had theater actors like Prakash Belavadi and Rajesh Sharma. So there were like different disciplines on the sets, and yet all of us, we synergized and we did a couple of workshops, and it was a big idea that we should in fact do some workshops before we hit the sets, and that I think worked brilliantly because it gave us a chance to understand each other, understand every single character.
Right.
Because otherwise, as an actor, when you read the script, you read it very selfishly. You want to know what you do anyway. But when we did these workshops through the discussion, and when Vivek was discussing individually with everyone, I think all the others also understood every single character. And from there began such a wonderful journey of helping each other, growing to our characters. If we hadn't done these workshops, then I think thoda one-upmanship ho jata hai, because everybody is a wonderful actor, everybody is a great actor.
Right.
So everyone wants to supersede the other person. But that did not happen, thankfully, due to the workshops that we did. We also kind of came together, we were eating together for 2 days, and we were singing together, and we were also chit-chatting, we were also talking about the script. So I think that gave us a time for all of us to just come together, be friends, and help each other through.
And that shows on screen, you know, when you watch the film, although, you know, you'll see like the whole committee is very divided with people for and against the so-called theory of what happened to Shastriji, but that energy in that room is because offset we exchanged that energy, and you can't lie to the camera. You can see that we were so well versed with each other and each other's habits, or with each other and our energy. It shows on screen.
Yeah, like even if you have to be nasty to someone, there has to be a certain chemistry, right?
Some comfort, yeah. Like she's nasty to me in the film, but also
nasty to everyone.
Yeah.
So what exactly is your character? What will you, how will you describe your character?
My character, I play a historian in the film. Her name is Aisha Alisha. And she is an intellectual. She's written a lot of books. Her word is the last word in history. She's got a Padma Shri from the government, so obviously she comes from, you know, some background, and she comes with a lot of baggage. And everything that she's gotten so far in life has made her too full of herself, and for correct reasons also, maybe. She's very nawabi, she's very entitled, and she's also crippled, so she's in a wheelchair all the time. So I guess, you know, that also brings out certain amount of frustration from within, but she's constantly, you know, snapping at people, and she thinks she's, you know, God's gift to this world, and the world wouldn't have existed had Aisha Alisha not walked, you know, down on this earth. Everyone else is peasants, you know, they're all peasants for her. So it's one of those kind of characters, and I've had fun playing her because the kind of face that God has given me, I've always played such good characters, and you know, they were like, achhi bhali ladki, achhi maa, achhi beti.
Can you believe such a pleasant...
Yeah, so it was great to break the mold and do something different, you know, for a change.
Such a pleasant smiling face, and yes. She's not allowed to smile. Can you believe it?
Can you imagine?